Kraft presents The Great Gildersleeve. Each week at this time from Hollywood, California, Kraft presents Harold Perry as The Great Gildersleeve, written by Leonard L. Levinson. We'll hear from the great Gildersleeve in just a moment. But first, what if you hadn't ridden in an automobile since the old Model T days, and then a friend gave you a ride in a fast, smooth-running modern automobile? Wouldn't that convince you there'd been some changes made? Well, if you haven't tasted margarine for a good long time, you'll get that same kind of surprise when you try Parquet margarine, the margarine that's made by Kraft. Yes, you just can't imagine how downright good-tasting modern margarine can be till you've tried delicious Parquet. That's why, with food prices rising, so many housewives are using Parquet margarine, serving it at the table, using it for baking and pan frying, too. Because this modern margarine, Parquet margarine, not only has a delicate, satisfying flavor the whole family loves, it's also an economical source of food values the whole family needs. Yes, Parquet margarine is a wholesome, highly nutritious energy food. And every pound contains 9,000 units of important vitamin A. So don't make up your mind about any margarine till you found out how good, delicious, nourishing Parquet is. Tomorrow, sure, ask your dealer for Parquet. P-A-R-K-A-Y. Now let's visit our friend, the great Gildersleeve, as he and Marjorie and Leroy wait in the Summerfield Railroad Station for the arrival of that well-known authoress, lecturer, and second cousin, Octavia Gildersleeve.
Yes?
I'm sure you'll be able to recognize cousin Octavia.
Oh, yes, my dear. Although I haven't seen her for years, her face comes back to me frequently in nightmares.
Gee, what did she look like, Unc?
Well, Leroy, did you ever see the USS Idaho in a bad storm?
No.
Then stick around when she gets off.
She's been very successful as a writer, hasn't she?
Yes, yes. She's the author of Is Your Child a Problem, or Why Bring That Up? Yes, she was first to advocate a policy of never striking a child except in self-defense.
How long is Cousin Octavia going to be here, Uncle Moore?
Just between trains. She's on a lecture tour and has to hop around the country. Seems her new manager doesn't know much about geography. He booked her alphabetically.
How's that?
She's on her way from Akron to Albuquerque. And from there, she goes to Altoona, Pennsylvania, then Amarillo, Texas, and then Atlantic City.
Gee, at that rate, you won't get to talk in Summerfield for years.
Yeah, it's nice, isn't it? Oh, and there she is. Well, well, well. Hello, Octavia. I'm Throckmorton.
Oh, Throckmorton. Well, let me look at you. Now, turn around.
Yes.
Oh, yes, I'd have known you any place.
Yes, yes. This is Marjorie and Leroy, and this is your cousin Octavia.
Oh, well, hello, glad to meet you. How's everything on the Idaho, cousin Octavia?
Idaho?
You mean Jack. You got his battleship mixed. I mean, how is cousin Sibley? Still got his seat on the stock exchange?
Oh, no, he lost it.
Yeah. How's your little daughter, Lulabelle?
Oh, you mean Barbara Ann? Well, here she is, right here.
Oh, I didn't know you were going to bring her along. Children, meet your little cousin.
Barbara Ann. Here's cousin Throckmorton, cousin Marjorie, and cousin Leroy.
I am very pleased to meet you, cousin Throckmorton, cousin Marjorie, and cousin Leroy.
Isn't she just a little doll? I do hope she can come home for lunch.
Yeah. Oh, no, I'm sorry, Marjorie, but our train for Albuquerque leaves in 6 or 7 minutes.
Oh, that's too bad. We would have enjoyed having you.
Yeah. Well, I would have liked to, but when one's public makes as many demands upon one as mine does on me, well, one must flit about like a butterfly, mustn't one?
Quiet, Leroy.
I didn't say anything.
Oh.
However, I'll be returning this way again next week, and if you're really determined to... Well, Barbara Ann can stay here with you, and I'll pick her up next Thursday.
Yes, that'll be splendid, my dear.
Oh, now, isn't that nice? And won't you have a good time, Barbara Ann?
I don't know.
Will I, Mother?
Of course you will.
Yes. And I know just what room we'll give you, too.
So do I. My room.
Yeah.
Now, oh, isn't that hospitable of Leroy? Oh, really, now that you've whipped us off our feet, I'm a little sorry I let you persuade me. But you must promise to take good care of Mother's little treasure.
Now, Octavia, you needn't worry yourself into a new set of wrinkles. We'll take good care of her. She's as welcome as long as she wants to stay here. By the way, how soon will you be back to pick her up?
Well, let's see. Oh, in a week or 8 days at the most. Now, there are Barbara Ann's bags. Oh, here's her music portfolio. Music. Now, be sure she practices her piano and vocalizing every day, won't you?
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, now, Barbara Ann, before Mother gets on the train, I want one little word alone with you, darling. You'll be cute as won't you?
Oh, yes.
Yes,
sure. Go right ahead. Go ahead.
Now, darling. I want you to promise me you'll be a good girl while you're visiting Cousin Throckmorton.
You know me, Mama.
Yes, I know you. That's why I'm warning you, young lady. Now, remember, no stuffing pillows and chimneys like you did at Uncle Sandy's, or painting the baby green, which you did at Aunt Sylvia's. I won't have it!
Really, Mother, don't raise your voice. It's so middle class.
Oh, sometimes I wonder if you're deserving of all I'm doing for you, Barbara Ann. Writing these books and making these lecture tours. You just don't seem to appreciate it.
Oh, pipe down, Mother. I'll lay on the floor and scream.
Oh, no more time for fond farewell, my dear. That cousin Octavia's train is ready to pull up. Now, Barbara Ann, I want you to be a brave.
We interrupt the program for a special bulletin. Tokyo, Monday, December 8th. Japan went to war against the United States and Great Britain today with air and sea attacks against Hawaii, followed by a formal declaration of hostilities. Japanese Imperial Headquarters announced at 6 a.m., that's 4 p.m. Sunday Eastern Standard Time, that a state of war existed among these nations in the Western Pacific as of dawn. Shortly afterwards, Domai announced that naval operations are progressing off Hawaii with at least one Japanese aircraft carrier in action against Pearl Harbor, the American naval base in the island. We return you now to the great Gildersleeve.
Well, if you were to ask me.
Leroy, nobody asked you.
Well, go ahead. Ask me, I dare you.
Yes. Quietly, Leroy.
It was well done, Barbara.
Yes.
Can I have my quarter now?
A quarter?
Yes, I always get a quarter when I play. Sometimes my father gives it to me even before I'm finished.
Yes. Yes, I'm beginning to see why. Well, here you are, young lady. Now, you and Leroy run along somewhere and play.
All right, Uncle Mort.
All right, Uncle Mort.
What do you mean, Uncle Mort? He's just a cousin to you.
Lovely, innocent youth.
Oh, say, Uncle Mort.
Yes, Marjorie.
You haven't been trying on my hats, have you?
Don't be silly. I haven't had on a lady's hat since the last time I went course not.
Well, it must have been Barbara Ann. And she's wrecked them.
Oh, my dear, not her. Why, she's a regular little angel, a little... Why, Leroy, what's wrong? What is it, Leroy? Where's Bertie this morning?
Oh, she's busy serving Barbara Ann her breakfast in bed.
I had breakfast in bed at morning school once. Some of the other guys filled my bunk with cornflakes.
Next. Told Bertie that she's had breakfast in bed ever since she was born.
Oh, well, I did too, up to a certain point, and they bought me a high chair. Yeah. Ah, good morning, Bertie. Can I have my breakfast now, please?
Just as soon as I fix some other eggs for Missy Barbara Ann.
Missy Barbara Ann?
Yes, so that's what she said for me to call her. And by the way, is a bandana handkerchief around here anywhere? She wants me to wrap my head up in one.
Bertie, I wish you'd stop playing topsy to her little Eva. Get some breakfast for the rest of
it. I'm sorry, Miss Gildersleeve. I can't do it just now. I got the little girl 2 minute eggs about 35 seconds too well done by mistake. And now she wants some rectified. Is that anything like scrambled?
Oh, she just wants them done over again.
Say, Bertie, have you got my lunch back yet?
Oh, I know there was something I just remembered. I'll fix it for you the minute I finish giving Barbara Ann her manicure.
Oh, yes, those pale hands she loves so well, yes.
Leapers, I gotta leave for school right now. You better give me some money to buy lunch or something.
Yes, all right. Here's 30 cents. Will that be enough?
Too much. Here's a dime back.
Huh?
I don't think I'll be able to eat more than four hot dogs.
Young man, don't you dare eat four hot dogs. Have something else, too.
Okay, two hot dogs and two hamburgers.
Yes. We shouldn't let things like this happen around here, Bertie. What are you looking for, Bertie?
Oh, I've got to find some paper and a pencil, Mr. Gildersleeve.
A paper and a pencil? What do you want them for?
Well, I don't know exactly why myself. Well, Miss Barbara Ann done told me she wants me to draw her a bath. Yeah.
Uncle Mort's going to be pretty angry when he comes home and finds out what you've done.
Oh, Leroy, don't be so juvenile. He'll thank me when he sees how nicely I've washed out all his pipes.
It smells so much sweeter now.
Well, it was bad enough putting them in soap and water, but spraying them with Marjorie's perfume was just too much.
Well, you just wait and see, Marty. Oh, I'm so bored. What do we do now?
Well, I don't know what you're going to do, but I got to go down and have my hair cut.
Oh, good. I'll go along with you. And after you're through, you can take me to the drugstore for an ice cream soda.
Not indoor. What do you think I am, made of money? I took you there yesterday for a soda, and you had three of them. Gee, you drank up my allowance for 3 weeks and half an hour.
But you have 50 cents now. I saw Cousin Throckmorton give it to you.
That's for my haircut.
Well, I don't see why you have to throw away your money in barbershop, but I can give you a lovely haircut myself.
You?
Oh, yes. I cut my father's hair all the time.
Oh, I don't believe you.
I'll just cut your hair to prove it. After all, I owe it to you.
What do you mean you owe it to me?
Well, you've been so nice to me. I want to earn this half a dollar so I can see you.
Gee, I don't know.
Oh, come on. Don't be so adolescent.
Okay, but... Well, what do you mean I'm adolescent? I had them taken out the same time they took out my contract.
We interrupt the program to bring a report from the Panama Radio. A Jap aircraft carrier was sunk off Honolulu, according to the Panama Radio. May we repeat that? According to the Panama Radio, a Jap aircraft carrier was sunk off Honolulu, according to Panama Radio. We return you now to Hollywood.
Nice, because after dinner, I'll... Leroy, take off your cap.
Well, okay.
Oh, my goodness, put it back on again. I'll take it off a little at a time so I get used to it. Now, see here, Leroy.
Now, if you'll just let me explain, Uncle, I didn't go to any barber.
I'll say you didn't. That man wasn't even a good butcher.
You still don't get it, Uncle. This was a homemade job.
Yes, Cousin Throckmorton. I tried my best to persuade Leroy not to do it, but he insisted on cutting his hair himself.
Oh, me?
Yes, you. No, you did.
Oh, Leroy, how could you? Now, see here, Barbara Ann.
Take your fist out of your little cousin's face, Leroy. It's unsanitary. Now, what's the meaning of all this?
Well, Leroy said he wanted to use the haircut money to buy ice cream sodas with.
What a liar.
And so at first he tried to get me to cut his hair for him.
What? Did I get you outside, barbed wire, Annie?
And then for clippers, he used your electric razor. Oh, he got jammed up and smoke started coming out. And it got so hot I couldn't hold it. Oh, I mean, he couldn't hold it.
See?
Are you sure you're telling the truth, Barbara? Oh, of course, Cousin Margie. Leroy made me do it.
Now, I guess I made you grab up the 50 cents and run down to the drugstore and eat 5 sodas in succession, too.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay. Call up the drugstore, Uncle Mort, and find out who they had to use the stomach pump on.
Barbara Ann, was it you?
Sure it was. She came back and told me all about it. The little glutton was gloating.
This conversation is becoming too, too utterly vulgar. In fact, it has ceased to be amusing.
Well, what's gotten into her? I don't know whether it's heartburn or heartburn. Come back here, young lady.
Yes, Barbara Ann. Now, you behave yourself. And sit down.
Oh, very well.
We'll go into this thing later. I haven't got any time now. That old goat Judge Hooker will be butting in here any moment.
Who's Judge Hooker?
Oh,
the probate judge who has to approve Uncle Mort's administration of our estate.
Yes. I want that legal buzzard to okay my annual report. Oh,
that must be him now. I'll answer it.
It's him, all right. Leroy, maybe you better put your cap on again. Yes, that's much better. Just weigh the old forest plaster. Oh, hello there, Judge. How are you this evening?
Pretty shy, pretty shy.
Huh?
Hello, Leroy.
Hello.
Well, who's this see little Miss Gildy.
Oh, this is little Barbara Ann Gildersleeve, Judge. Barbara, and this is Judge Hooker.
Oh, is this Judge Hooker?
Yeah.
Why, somehow I expected you to have a little white chin whisker from what Cousin Throckmorton said.
Well, what did I say that gave you that impression, child?
Didn't you say he was an old goat?
Watch this.
That's just a little cold, Judge. Barbara, would you like to sing Pale Hands on the Piano for the judge?
You mean so he'll okay your report?
You.
What's this? Is that the reason you invited me to dinner, Gildersleeve?
Oh, no, Judge, not at all.
My children, I thought that was the case. I'd turn you down flatter than a stranded soprano.
Barbara, I think we've heard enough.
So do I.
Now, please leave the room, young lady.
All right, Cousin Throckmorton. Glad to have met you, Judge Hooker.
Well, Gildersleeve, now that we're alone, take off your coat.
Now, Judge, don't be hasty.
Take off your coat, Gildersleeve.
I don't want to fight with you, Judge.
Neither do I, but the little brat's in to kick me sign on the back of your coat.
What?
More war bulletins. London, Monday. The British Parliament was called into special session for 3 p.m. today to hear a government statement, which everyone agreed would be a declaration of war against Japan. That was expected to coincide with similar action by the United States. Sitka, Alaska. A blackout was ordered for tonight at this site of a naval air station as police officials began a roundup of questionable characters. We return you now to Hollywood.
That child is her imagination. She's never been farther south than the first balcony had gone with the wind.
Oh, I think you're doing the poor little thing an injustice, too.
What?
Okay, okay. Any opinions I express are purely my own and not to be misconstrued by nobody else.
Bertie, I think we can leave you out of this conference.
Yes, I'll go, but why?
Well, I'm afraid you might turn into another Mata Hari.
Me? Why, thank you, Mr. Tilsley. That's the nicest compliment I've had in years.
Yeah. Now, look, children. Cousin Octavia isn't due for 5 days yet. This is a desperate situation, and it needs desperate measures. I hate to do this. Doesn't set you a very good example.
What are you going to do, Uncle Moore?
I haven't the faintest idea. But whatever it's going to be, it won't be honest.
Can't we just take her out into the country someplace and lose her?
Leroy, isn't that kind of a cat?
Yes, Marjorie.
That child has gotten me in wrong with every one of my boyfriends.
Oh.
Gee, that's tough to hear.
Especially just before Christmas.
Yes. Hey, I know what we'll do. We'll send Cousin Octavia a telegram.
What kind of a telegram?
Well, listen to this. You better take this down.
Oh, okay.
Mrs. Octavia Gildersleeve, Fred Harvey Hotel, Albuquerque, New Mexico. Dearest darling Mama, I'm terribly, terribly homesick for you. I don't think I can stand it another minute longer.
Nice, I get lonesomer for you every day. Please come soon, your loving daughter, Barbara Ann. Will you hear that, Mr. Llewellyn?
Sorry, don't wait.
Oh. Really? It doesn't sound anything like her.
Well, she's probably sick, suffering from lonesomeness.
Well, there's another relative Barbara Ann is disposed of. I'm really coming to the end of my Gildersleeve.
Tough luck.
Well, I'll see. I'll do my lecture tonight. By tomorrow, pick up my baby, go on to Altoona.
Oh, Mrs. Gildersleeve, we just had a wire saying the Altoona date is out, and they pushed up your Amarillo lecture.
Oh, of course. But that means I can't go to Summerfield for weeks.
That's correct.
Oh, and I can't leave my little girl with those unkind Summerfield relatives.
And why not, Quay?
Well, I'm almost tempted. Oh, no, no, no. Mr. Llewellyn, I've got an idea.
Oh, no. When you get an idea in your head and a look in your eye, you better also get a new secretary on your payroll.
Who else have I got to turn to?
Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Gildersleeve. I'd swim the widest river. I'd climb the highest mountain. But Woosifer Llewellyn refuses to play nursemaid again to that widow brat of yours, not for all the kangaroos in Australia.
But, Mr. Llewellyn, as my secretary, it's your job to go where I send you.
Oh, but, Mrs. Gildersleeve, I'm allergic to your little girl. Don't you remember the time in Buffalo when she flew all my trousers out of the train window?
Oh, why, that was just one of her girly pranks.
Quanks, whips, lassoies. There's been 100 similar peccadilloes. It's enough to make a grown man cry. No, I won't do it. I won't go. Absolutely no.
Another law bulletin. New York. Reports received by the Associated Press from Europe tonight said the German army was preparing an effort to take both Moscow and Leningrad and recapture Rostov within 2 weeks in a move linked with the outbreak of war in the Pacific. We return you now to Hollywood.
I didn't know what you said in your telegram.
What telegram?
The one you sent begging your mother to rescue you from Brockmorton P. Gildersleeve.
I never sent any such message. Now, you can go right back and tell her so.
This is just another twit. Now, I got a taxi waiting outside, so you hurry and pack your luggage.
I'll do nothing of the kind. I like it here, and I'm staying.
I'll just give you till I count to three to start getting ready. One, two, three.
You wait here. I'll be right back. Oh, Cousin Throckmorton?
Yes?
There's the strangest man in the living room.
Oops.
He says he's my mother's secretary, and he wants me to go away with him.
You?
But I never saw him before in my life.
What? Are you sure?
Oh, yes. And he talks in the most suspicious way.
This looks serious, my dear. It might be a kidnapper. You can stay here, and I'll investigate. Now, don't get excited. Take it easy. Keep calm, keep calm, keep calm. Good day, sir. What did you want?
My name is Lucifer Llewellyn. I came to take Barbara Ann away.
Oh, you did, eh?
Yep. I'm her mother's secretary. She wants me to bring her to Amarillo.
Amarillo? I thought Octavia was passing through here on her way to Altoona.
Oh, no, she had to change her plan.
A what? Oh, her plan. Well, the first time I've heard of that.
Time you've heard of it.
Yeah.
Didn't you get a telegram saying I was going to arrive today?
No, I didn't, Mr. Llewellyn.
Oh, excuse me. The name is Llewellyn, not Llewellyn.
Yeah.
Oh, dear, I wish this job was over already. I don't like it.
Yeah, neither do I.
Look, I'll come right out and tell you. If this little brat gives me the least bit of trouble, I'm going to throw a flour sack over her head and swag her away.
Yeah. Oh. You are, eh?
Yeah.
Well, Mr. Llewellyn, if you don't mind, I'd like to have you step right in here.
For joy, but this don't look like it.
In you go!
Oh, help! You let me run!
No! I'll hold you for a while, Mr. Kidnapper.
Help! Police!
Yeah, I'll get you the police. By George, that's who I will get. Oh, who can that be? Yes, all right, I'm coming. Oh, telegram? Thank you, boy. Oh, now what's this? Rockmorton P. Gildersleeve, unable to pick up Barbara and myself, sending Secretary Mr. Llewellyn Octavia. Oh, my goodness, this explains everything.
Let me out of here. Come on, you two. Let me out of here.
Oh, you're coming, Mr. Llewellyn. It's all a mistake, sir.
Put up your jokes, Gildersleeve.
Yeah?
I'm going to wham-face you from here to next party. Come on and fight, you big palooka.
Now, calm down. Take it easy, Mr. Llewellyn. What? It's all a mistake.
Oh, it is.
Yes, until I got this telegram from Octavia, I thought you were a kidnapper.
What? Whatever gave you that erroneous impression?
Yes. Miss Barbara Ann, she said she'd never seen you before.
That settles it. I'm through. I resign. I retire.
Yeah, well, I don't blame you. Of course, you see the little girl back to her mother first.
I'll see her someplace else first. Goodbye, Blackmore, and I hope I never see another Gildersleeve as long as I live.
More war bulletins. Washington. The Navy Department announced tonight that a censorship has been placed on all outgoing cablegrams and radio messages from the United States and its outlying possessions. Fort Lewis, Washington. All men who have been honorably discharged from the 9th Army Corps area during past months because of reaching the age of 28 were called back to active duty by the Army today. The men called back, including draftees, are members of the Active Reserve Corps. They were ordered to report to their induction board. This pertains to the Northwestern states. We return you now to Hollywood.
What's this? Whoopee! Hooray! Merry Christmas! Happy New Year!
Oh, Lord, what is it?
Yeah, tell us!
Cousin Octavia is flying to Atlantic City, and her plane stops at the airport 5 minutes this afternoon. She wants us to have Barbara Ann there, ready to travel.
Marvelous! Oh, Barbara Ann!
Yes, Barbara Ann!
Where are you, Barbara Ann?
thought.
I guess we're all ready to go to the airport.
I don't want to go. I want to stay here. I'm not going.
Oh, you're not going, eh? Yes, you are, young dear. We've got plenty of time. It's a full hour before that plane arrives. We're going to be on the safe side and get there early.
No, I want to stay here. I'll be good.
Yes, well, I guess I'll have to pick you up then. Yes. Oh, excuse me a moment, Barbara Ann. Hello?
Throckmorton.
Yes?
This is Octavia.
Oh, hello, Octavia. Where about you phoning from?
From the airport. Why aren't you down here?
It's airport. What are you talking about? Your plane isn't due until 4:35.
It's after 4:35 now. It's almost 4:40. What's the matter? Didn't you get my telegram? Why haven't you got Barbara Ann down here to go on the plane?
Oh, my goodness. Our clock's an hour slow. Just wait there, Octavia. We'll be right down.
Well, I can't. The plane is ready to take off. I've got a lecture in Atlantic City tonight. Oh, my goodness, they're calling for me.
When do you come back?
In another 2 weeks. Goodbye.
Yes, oh, I've got a headache.
What happened, Little Moss?
Our clock was an hour slow. Somebody's been fooling around with our clock. And I think I know who it was.
No. No, not me, Uncle Mort. I didn't do it.
Oh, this time you're going to get what's coming to you, young lady. You come here.
No, you wouldn't dare.
Oh, no? I want you to know that this is going to hurt you a lot more than it hurt me. Hail and by love. Yeah. There, young lady. That'll teach you to monkey with clocks.
Oh, by the way, Uncle Mort, Barbara Ann didn't do it. Don't you remember? It was you.
What? Oh, my goodness, it was. Leroy, why didn't you stop me?
Well, Uncle Mort, it's a funny thing, but I didn't think of it till after you were finished.
You're a bright boy, Leroy.
Gildersleeve will be with us again in a few minutes. But right now, I think you'll agree that there's one sure way to find out if you like something, and that's to try it yourself. So I want to suggest a little experiment, one that may mean a lot to you in the high-priced days ahead. Tomorrow, get a pound or two of parquet margarine, the delicious modern margarine made by Kraft. Take it home and serve it at the table. Use it for baking and pan frying. Yes, use parquet margarine in every way, and I think you'll be amazed at how downright good a modern margarine can be. You see, parquet margarine is no ordinary margarine. Parquet margarine is the result of Kraft's long experience in making quality food. Yes, taste parquet margarine once, and you'll know the difference. Parquet's delicate, appetizing flavor is sure to satisfy.